without showing the text. Okay, we were talking about Title 28, Judiciary and Judicial Procedure, where they define courts. We've done that one. That was page 7. District courts have original jurisdiction, but these are federal courts. You're not in a federal court. You're in a town court. All right.
Different courts.
In the federal system, it doesn't talk about state courts in that stuff.
Right.
Oh, here it says, 3, to redress the deprivation under color of any state law, statute, ordinance, regulation, custom or usage of any right, privilege, or immunity secured by the Constitution of the United States or by any act of Congress providing for equal rights of citizens or of all persons within the jurisdiction of the United States. This is, again, federal jurisdiction. You have federal jurisdiction if state courts violate your rights. Title 28, Part 4, Chapter 111, 1652. State laws as rules of decision. The laws of the several states, except where the Constitution or treaties of the United States or acts of Congress otherwise require or provide, shall be regarded as rules of decision in civil actions in the courts of the United States in cases where they apply. The courts. First Court. Title 18, Part 1, Chapter 1, Section 23.1. Court of the United States defined as used in this title, except where otherwise expressly provided. The term Court of the United States includes the District Court of Guam, the District Court for the Northern Mariana Islands, and the District Court of the Virgin Islands. Second Court. Title 26, Appendix. Title 2, The Court, Rule 10. Name of the court is the United States Tax Court. Hey, that's the second court. Then, Office of the Court. The principal office of the court. I guess, wait a second here. Well, that's talking about the tax court. And then you go through its offices and the sessions and the business hours of the clerk. That's all for the, and the mailing address. United States Tax Court. So to throw that at the judge, I think is a pain in the ass because he doesn't care about the authority of the tax court. Transfer to cure want of jurisdiction. Whenever a civil action is filed in a court as defined in section 610 of this title or appeal. Well, actually, what it's not clear from that is, are there other courts? There's a first and a second. It would be a nice thing to have a statement in there. That's all there are. Or there are other ones. There's a, I don't know what other one. Transfer to cure want of jurisdiction. Whenever a civil action is filed in a court as defined in section 610 of this title or an appeal, including a petition review of administrative action, is noticed for, filed, etc., etc. If it is in the interest of justice, transfer. That's a repetition. I think you've already stated that before.
Are you hearing?
No.
Oh, you can't even hear me.
No, you're talking too loud.
I'll tell you what I got to do. Maybe. Put the earphones on and see if that helps. It's only one ear.
I don't think that's legal.
No, oh, it's not legal, actually.
Right. But maybe we could switch drivers.
All right, I'll take off the earphones. Oh, that's true. Yeah. Yeah, I could drive. I guess what do you need? Just step on the gas, right?
You need the earphones. I can.
legal deal. Okay, Red Fox to Blue Bandit, do you have liftoff? Can you hear me?
Yeah, but not very well. It's not very nice.
Try that one good ear now. It should be really nice. Rattly sound. Well, I know it's only one side, so we're stuck with that part. But how's that one side? Oh, okay, let's try that. Oh, this is a drastic thing. Oh, thank you, thank you. You're a generous person. Okay, transfer to Kirwan of jurisdiction, 1631. That we have stated that whole paragraph before, I think.
Keep speaking up, it sounds better even here.
Title 26, yeah. Subtitle F, Chapter 76, Subchapter A, Section 7403. Action to enforce lien or to subject property to payment of tax. A. To issue orders, processes, and judgments. The district courts of the United... I don't understand why in the world we're raising district U.S. federal courts. This has nothing to do with the U.S. federal court system. This is a state court.
You're explaining all the jurisdictions.
And what do you think is the right answer?
Huh?
What's he going to say? We're an admiralty court?
Well, they wouldn't say it. It's not admiralty.
How about under the Constitution of New York State?
They're not even under that. They're a...
Doesn't say the United... The court, state of New York has different kind of courts and they're in counties and stuff?
What kind of court is this?
Well, just because they have a name. We're deceived by the name, but we're saying in substance, come forward and show who makes up your corporation and how you're here. What's your jurisdiction? Who are you?
Right.
But my guess is there would be a...
Well, we don't want to guess.
There's language in the New York Constitution, and there's statutes further, I would imagine, but I'm not sure on that.
Should go by the Constitution, and then your argument that you so skillfully put forward to that Judge Lamb and Saugerties, because you sent that in, right, Joe?
Yeah.
Did you get it? No, but Friendly sent it in. Joe Friendly, you say what you did. Why don't you pause?
What did I do?
Why don't you pause and wrap your rap?
My rap is just that it is appropriate before plea. When a defendant who was asked to plead says, I refuse to plea at this time because the law you're asking me to plead to shouldn't be there. It's an unconstitutional law. It should be struck down. And therefore, there's nothing to keep me in court over. And how about a hearing upon my showing of constitutional rights? Just look at Posar's papers and what we're supposed to have is a hearing whether there's a compelling state interest.
And you sent that by postage to tell everybody what you did. You wrote it out and you sent it by mail?
I sent a copy by mail to the judge, a copy to the DA, and a copy to the Secretary General, which is required in our procedures when you're challenging a state law as unconstitutional. They got to be in on the notice. So I gave them notice, And there has been no response.
Was there a return receipt requested, say, from the state attorney general? I've heard some people say it should go to the Secretary of State.
Or is it there? It's the Secretary of State of the United States?
No. I don't know. Did you get a return? I mean, it doesn't seem like you got any response, did you? I mean, you got something back in the mail that it was delivered.
I didn't send a return receipt request. And I just filled out an affidavit that said I sent it to him, and that was the address.
That's so good. And did you say anything to Judge Lamb that you wanted a response?
No, I didn't ask for a response.
It was a lame response, but we got a response. So we have to start telling these people, we're serious. If you want us to take you seriously, you have to say who you are. Without saying who you are, it's unconstitutional. We know who we are. We're Americans and we're following the Constitution. That's why your argument was really excellent. But for us to keep rolling over and saying, oh, well, they didn't answer us. Oh, well. We sort of get beaten into submission that we don't deserve an answer. And if we don't deserve an answer, who does? Not some other corporation.
This language that I'm reading here, like here we're talking about filing in any case where there's been a refusal or neglect to pay any tax.
A little louder, Joe.
In any case where there has been a refusal or neglect to pay any tax or discharge any liability in respect thereof, this is all federal rules about tax court. So that the judge would say, give me a break. What are you throwing that at me for? Then we have third court, venue generally. A civil action against a foreign state. So that's again, in the federal court system, they're defining under Title 28, venue against a foreign state.
Right, and we're saying the court we're in is a foreign state to us.
Yeah, you were saying that. And
doesn't it feel like it?
Joe don't get it at all.
But the judge treats you like family.
Number two is better.
Oh, here we go. The fourth court. Section 610. As used in this chapter, the word courts includes the courts of appeals and district courts of the United States. The U.S. District Court for the state. Oh, yeah, don't forget about the Canal Zone in Guam and Virgin Islands. The U.S. Court of Federal Claims and the Court of International Trade. And there's a fifth court. Where is the fifth court definition? Where's the site? Now, that's a mistake. And you didn't quite spell fifth right. You left out the H, but hey, come on. Now, the petitioners have pointed out in each of the federal statutes, cited the ways the courts... Oh, excuse me, I didn't say that right. Now, the petitioners have pointed out in each of the federal statutes cited the ways the court names are spelled and spells out the jurisdiction of the courts. There are no federal statutes that show that the U.S. District Court or the U.S. District Court exists, or one is spelled out U.S. and the other is United States, exists. There are no federal statutes that show that the United States District Court exists. Now, I missed something. How about the Fourth Court? Oh, it's
District Court of the United States exists. United States District Court is a fiction.
Oh, it's United States District Court for the District of Columbia. If you got a foreign state or a political subdivision thereof of a foreign state. Okay, so that's for the D.C. court. No, I'm really confused here. There are no federal statutes that show that the United States District Court exists. Oh, I see. That's... Oh, we don't know about the Fifth, so we don't know for sure on that one.
Can't hear you.
Without knowing what the Fifth is, it could be the Fifth.
No, the Fifth was all... IRS courts.
Or tax. But that was the second, was the tax court.
No, tax courts and IRS courts are different.
Oh.
Internal Revenue Service is a different
thing. Oh, boy.
Motivated and wise people did a lot of research about the IRS and which Rod Klass's people benefited from. So we're looking at a tradition that's been building up of people who know that they're free and they really ponder it legally. And so tax courts, IRS, property taxes, pot busts, mortgages, they're all related in these cash register courts that have Dun & Bradstreet numbers and trade on indictments. We really have in prison some very important contributors to our society.
My problem is this. You're saying that in the federal statutes, in the Constitution, all that good stuff, they don't define the jurisdiction or the existence of the United States District Court other than Guam and the Virgin Islands and the District of Columbia.
No, and District Courts of the United States.
There are those, you say?
Yes, there are those. But they scammed us. Instead of everybody going into the District Courts of the United States, they created this legal fiction called the United States District Court in all capital letters. That's a fictitious court. It doesn't have constitutional sanctions. It's not a constitutional court.
But how can it even exist?
So why are you going federal? When you were talking state court.
Because the state courts are the same. They're all under that same phony jurisdiction.
I don't agree on that. I would say that the state courts have their jurisdiction under New York state law.
Oh, yeah, Joe, there's real state courts, too, but not these ones.
But
what
even
is this court called?
Even in the state of New York, it's the District Court of the State of New York. Not New York State District Court. They just play with the names. They make it sound like a legitimate court. But it's actually not.
What do they call it?
I agree that they have the word district in some of the, we call them judicial district.
So they have...
U.S. Court for the, is it the second?
Have you ever looked at a map?
Molly and I really giggled when Joe offered us something once, you know, to drink, and instead of asking for a sip or offering a sip, would you like a sip? Do you want a hit? We just thought that was hilarious.
Some habits die hard. No, but in the county, there there should be a map of the judicial districts.
There should be a map of the judicial districts.
Yes, there probably is. We'll go, like we went down to the deed office, Maggie. We can go to that office and find that too. It's really worth it to do this kind of research. And then what's wonderful about the internet is you can share your research with others.
Are we getting off now? Are we home,
no,
Daddy?
No, I'm getting gas.
Oh, does this gas have a bathroom?
Yes. We can take a break.
Yeah, okay.
How far is it, Daddy?
Yeah.
About another hour.
Another hour? And we have to walk through that those portals at 5:30?
Yeah.
That's curious.
I'm not so convinced the sound is working. Maybe it's the headset.
Oh, the wires.
It seems it should be more robust.
Seems like I should be able to turn up the volume. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. what you're saying about playing jail. Oh.